25th July 1995, and new guidelines were issued by the SEBI, that is Security Exchange Board of India, which were implemented from December 4, 1996, and it was given a brief as follows. First of all, the government has issued the guidelines for the venture capital fund companies. So, the government had issued on 25th November 1989. Then the changes were made in the 1995 by the SEBI. SEBI is the Security Exchange Board of India, and which they made in the 4th December. Sorry, they made in the July 1995, and it was implemented from when it was started from 4th December 1996. Now the first part, the establishment.
They sincerely do the duties, the director of the company, the officer, the employer.
second part. If the thrust applies for equity shares or derivatives. So the company is seeking this spot meaning name is not listed. So for that company also, in the related part or related goods and services, you can use it. In the third, the company is providing the financial services. And also in the condition of the A and for B, then the investor cannot be paid in such company. The company is doing the financial services. Though it has not recognized, though it has not listed, so you can't invest that, use that. So this is the first is established. Second, permission of the seller. For qualification, qualification is divided into two categories. The expert of form of company and the vice of form of a trust applies for the venture capital fund. Next is certificate of sanction. Next is the investment. Next is limit of the use of the fund. And the last part is since the last few years, mutual fund has emerged as a new institution in the capital market. Majority of the nationalized bank and the financial organization have established mutual funds. So here we can say it is a new institution, and from a majority part in the capital market, it's related to the mutual fund. So from the last few years, so it is giving very importance in the capital market. Even the majority of the nationalized bank and the financial organization have established the mutual fund as well. It is made a substantial progress in becoming the helpful in the capital investment sector. We can see that it is making very important steps towards our capital market. Now the government is considering to and expand the scope of the mutual fund in the private and the joint sector also. So now the government is also initiating to expand this market in the private sector as well as the joint sector also. The government has empowered the SEBI, that is Securities Exchange Board of India, to frame the guidelines, principle for it, and to keep an eye on its function. So government is allowing the SEBI to make proper standards, to make proper principles, to make proper functions, and according to that, the things are going on or not. You check it to keep your eye on it. For creation of the mutual fund, a proper governance structure should be framed. If you required. So mutual funds are classified into two groups, which are as under. So they have explained us the mutual fund into the two parts. The first part is open-ended scheme. That is one. last. Do the master shares are placed under the open-ended schemes in the mutual fund? The mutual fund schemes give the benefit of the high, easy liquidity, safety, any income tax to its investors. The bank also gives benefit of obtaining the funds from the new sector and investors, of course. With the entry of the commercial bank in the mutual fund sectors, the monopoly of the UTI, that is the Unit Trust of India, the Life Insurance Corporation, LIC, is no more operating. And that at the time, its entry in the commercial bank has become helpful stabilizing the stock. But they would do more important and useful only when it becomes successful in maintaining additional saving and its investment is made in the primary industrial sector of the continent. The major benefit of the commercial bank is that its several branches are spread over far of rural areas. So in the long run, maximum money can be collected from the rural people through the mutual fund. Moreover, money can be collected from market and the urban middle class people also from 2012 to 40. The performance of the mutual fund can be evaluated from the following things. So here they say that the impact was UTI and LIC was putting in, so it is now operating fund. Just because for the mutual fund, they are classified into two ways. One is the open scheme and the second is the loose scheme. So you can't deposit any sales in the primary market or open market or the secondary market, you can do that. Even they have specified here the one tabular form. So in the private sector of the mutual fund and the public sector of the mutual fund. So cross mobilization, the movable part of the bank account is here 8,49,397. So net assets presently is 48.88. So 91% even in this percentage they have specified. So the, in the year 2012-13 and 13-14 they have specified the data for the public as well as the private sectors. So the total part they have compared in the percentage part. So in private sector in 2013 mobility is around 82.4 and in the public sector is 9.4. So net asset value is around 9.8 in the private sector and for the public sector 8.4. So for the year 2012-13. So for the 12-13, see in the public sector it is increasing compared to the private sector. In private sector it has slightly gone down. So 81.6 in the net asset value, that is net asset is 85.1%. So this data is specified by the Data Statistical Authority of India in the year 2014-15. So the mutual funds, it is divided into the two categories. The first part is the open-ended scheme of the mutual fund. The second part is the closed-ended scheme of the mutual fund. Even in this lecture, we have studied the guidelines, specified guidelines for the venture capital fund companies. So it was government has started it in the 20th November 1989. After that, it was amended in the July 1995. So finally it is implemented, it was amended by the SEBI and finally it is implemented from the 4th December 1986. So even for that they have specified us the 7 point that we have discussed. So the first point was the establishment. The second is the permission of the SEBI, it is very essential part. If you want to start the venture capital fund companies for that the permission is also essential. The third is the qualification. Qualification means the eligibility for what type you want to start with, and the documentations are clear according to the article and particular memorandum. There is no restrictions or some prohibitions are not there. So if the SEBI is going to allow you, then you can do it. If it is not going to allow you, you can't do it. So for that, they specify the case of the company as well as the trust applies for the venture capital fund. So next part is certificate of the sanction. If you are qualified, if everything is okay, if documentation is proper, then SEBI will sanction that part. They will allow it. If it is not okay, then they are not going to allow it. So they will reject it. Next is the investment. So here they specify the minimum investment of the 5 lakh. Limit also discuss, suppose the venture capital funds, you have to where you can utilize that. And the last part is the listing prohibition. Till what time the listing will be prohibited, so they are specified for the 3 years. So these are the seven points we have discussed, and even we have discussed the mutual funds into the two types, open-ended scheme mutual funds.